This is a walkthrough on how to create a drop-down column in Google Sheets versus a drop-down column in Coda and comparing the differences. So if we have a list of projects here, project, owner, and a status column, if I want to give my teammates an ability to click on a drop-down here, I can select the cells, data validation, and I can start adding some rules about what should be as options. So maybe the first one is complete, next one is in progress, next one is not started, and then the final one would be, let's say, at risk. And then we can also, of course, pick some nice colors here for each of these statuses, and let's take a look at our dropdown. We now have a nice little dropdown where I can say complete, in progress. Let me just expand this a little bit. Pretty much as expected, I can even copy and paste here, which is kind of neat. If I want to do something really fast. And this should work for most people. Coda is pretty similar. I have a status column. Oh, by the way, we also have these new custom icons where you can like add GIFs or GIFs in addition to custom icons to your doc. But I'm going to go to a select list type, click on new. And similarly, I can say this will be complete. This will be the yellow, I think, was in progress. Is that right? Green is not started, and then red is at risk. Click this fifth option. And similarly, I can just click on dropdowns. So far, so good. It's pretty similar to Google Sheets. I can copy and paste here as well, similar to Google Sheets. And that's all fine and dandy. But most of you who are using dropdowns are probably using Google Sheets with a custom drop-down list where you might have like something like a status, like lookup table down here, statuses. And I'll say here I have, what is it, complete? Complete, in progress, not started, at risk. And instead of doing these as like manual drop-downs, I would want to look up to this table because I might want to change what my options are. I don't want to have to constantly go into data validation to do this. Data validation, and I have to constantly edit these options where I can just make it some list in my Google Sheet. So instead of clicking on dropdown, I can say dropdown from a range, click on this, and select the range, which is just these four cells from A13, A12 to A15, hit OK. And notice how Google Sheets automatically picks up what's listed in these cells. So similarly, I can click on the colors. Let's start it at risk. Done. And same thing. I have a similar dropdown. And it works. Just like it would with the way when I manually typed out what was in the data validation. The only difference here is that this is actually referencing specific cells in my Google Sheet. In Coda, a status column here, I can just go to select list options and say convert to table. And I want to call this table statuses below, put the location below the current table, hit create. And it automatically creates this status column. And this is also a lookup to this table. So if I want to add an additional row here, let's say I want to call this super done. And maybe I want to color this like a pink or something like that. This is now an option that I can select in my dropdown list. In Google Sheets, if I put in super done here, it doesn't automatically get picked up in my dropdown. And that's because of data validation. I have to select these cells, go to data, data validation, and change this formula to reference the new cells I'm adding. Reselect this, hit OK, hit done, close this out, and now I have super done as an option. And also kind of sucks that my colors went away, so I have to recolor this again. So I'm just going to do this really quick, and then not started, sure, whatever. And a little more manual effort there, so not as user-friendly, I would say. Another thing is, let's say I have in progress, but I have two in progresses. One is like in progress 50%. And then I have another in progress, let's say this one, let's move this up here. This one is in progress 75%. Look what happened when I changed this to 50%. These that were originally in progress automatically changed to in progress 50%. If I change this to 5%, it automatically changes this lookup because this is always tied to this table. So as you can see here, if I want to change this in progress, I'll change this background color really quick to a purple. This in progress 75% is also a selectable option in my dropdown. In Google Sheets, if I want to change this in progress, I'm just going to expand this a little more, expand in progress 50%. Look what happened to my in progress dropdowns. They're saying that this is an input must fall within the specified range. And so if you are in a very fast moving project and your statuses are changing a lot or changing sometimes, and you want to quickly apply that to all the rows in your projects table, you have to go through each row and select that in progress 50%. You can probably copy and paste here. What I've typically seen people do is you first filter. So we have these three error columns. The first thing you do is you filter this column on just the like in progress ones and get rid of the super duns. So these are all wrong. So I would actually manually click 50% and then just copy and paste over those, undo the filter, and then now my dropdown is correct. Again, if I want to add another in progress 75% here, the data validation doesn't automatically pick it up. Of course, people could say, oh, you could just do like one of those like count A formulas where you like count to the bottom of this sheet to the last value in the cells. I mean, it's a little more manual work, but it's doable, but just not very simple to use. So dropdowns here are limited in terms of like flexibility, and in Coda, it just kind of works when you have another table of statuses and they're just linked together here. One extra cool thing with status, with these lookups and these relationships is that I can create a linked relation, and now I can actually see in this table of my statuses, which projects fall within that status. And if I happen to change complete class trailer, which is right now as super done, see how it's right here? If I change this to be not started, complete class trailer automatically moves to not started. Similarly, if I want to say in this column, another project that is in the not started phase is launch, that automatically goes back here. So it's a two-way kind of relationship, whereas in Google Sheets, you definitely don't have that type of functionality. So there you go. That's the difference between dropdowns in Google Sheets versus Coda.